first in tonight's News for Health, powered by HealthKey.com. We all know about hair loss in men.
Well, it's also one of the most common cosmetic problems in women, but something they rarely want to talk about. For most women, their hair is a big part of who they are. Unfortunately, women's hair loss is mistakenly viewed as a male disease. In fact, women make up 40% of American hair loss sufferers.
The interesting fact is that it's just as common in women as it is in men.
The most common form of hair loss in women is hereditary hair loss, and it can start as early as the teenage years.
If you notice that you're shedding more hair and there's thinning that's associated with it, and it's primarily localized to the top of the scalp, you may have female pattern hair loss.
Recently, Miss Delaware announced she had alopecia areata, a common autoimmune disease resulting in the excessive loss of hair on the scalp and elsewhere on the body. But she hasn't let the loss of her hair hold her back from taking the crown.
I hope to show people that beauty comes in all different kinds of packages. You know, no beauty queen should fit into a box and look like a Barbie every time that they wake up.
To some women, hair loss can be unacceptable.
For any female who is suffering from hair loss, it is a psychologically and physically devastating condition to deal with.
But there is treatment out there, and Dr. Jeffrey Miller from Penn State Hershey Medical Center urges women to seek help.
You can maintain what you have and hopefully improve upon what you have. It's very important. We can't cure female pattern hair loss, but with the appropriate intervention, we can slow down the progression.
And for more information on women's hair loss, you can go to our website, fox43.com, and click on health.